In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use multiple follow path constraints. There's a camera that is following a curve circle, and that is also tracking the cube. And the cube is following a curve. Let's create a curve circle. If you don't see a menu item that is shown in this tutorial, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. I'll scale it a bit. Please make sure the circle is set to 3D, not 2D. Let's reset the camera's location and rotation values to 0. I'll add a first follow path constraint to the camera. Now the camera is following the curve circle. Let's track the cube as well. This is how the scene looks like from the camera's perspective. I'll select two curve points and move them upward to make the animation more interesting. Let's add a curve point, make it 3D, and extrude it. Please activate the Extra Objects add-on, if you don't see this in the menu. Let's extrude it multiple times, and smooth the curve. I smoothed the curve by typing A, V, as in Victor, and A, in edit mode. Let's make the cube to follow the smooth curve. As we can see, the camera is still tracking the cube, but it's not moving along. In this example, I'll make the curve circle to travel with the cube, but the most ideal solution would be creating an empty, parenting to the cube, and make the empty to follow the curve point. That is better, because we're not limited to only follow a single object that way. We can also use multiple empty objects and make them follow different curves when the animation reaches certain frames. For now, I'll make the curve circle to follow the smooth curve. This was an easier solution for a simple scene, but when the scene gets complicated, it will be more difficult to control the animation flow. Please do experiment with the empty object parenting and constraining. In the past, I have also demonstrated how to use multiple cameras in animation projects. The final animation could look very sophisticated with multiple cameras and constraints, but in reality they're easy to make. Once you master this concept, you'll be able to create amazingly sophisticated animation sequences. I'll set the last frame to 100, so the animation would repeat forever. That is because the default length is set to 100. The length of curve animation can be controlled under Object Data Properties Path Animation category. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.